I have a second channel, Cube Compium TDX. Hey everybody. One of the biggest issues I've always had about Windows 10 is the fact that pretty much every half of a year they release a feature update, and it's the equivalent of having to do an upgrade install on your operating system, or in some cases do a reinstall on your operating system when the upgrade fails for some reason. Some of these feature upgrades or updates not only update your features, but they require sometimes new drivers or new software and stuff like that. And the thing is, drivers and certain software titles that were compatible with the first version of Windows 10, 1507, for example, may not work properly with the current version, which I believe is 20H2. So, pretty much every half a year, you get these new updates out, and you're not required to install them, but if you get more than, I believe, three versions behind, you no longer receive updates for your build. See, traditionally, for example, Windows 7, as long as you had Service Pack 1 installed, you were eligible for updates. Whereas with, and also Windows 8, as long as you had Windows 8.1, you were eligible for updates until, I think, 2023? And Windows 7, of course, updates and support for it expired last year, 2020. But Windows 10, it's, although the current build of Windows 10, which is 20H2, is also called Windows 10, just like the original build, 1507. And although they look a lot alike at the surface, they're quite different operating systems. So what I'm doing in this video is I'm going to do some testing. We've got this old Re Machine system from around 2005, 2006. It originally ran Windows XP. My grandpa used this machine, and it had Windows 10 on it. The last build of Windows 10 it was running was 1709, and to be honest, it was running it probably up until early 2019, something like that, early 2020 maybe. Yeah, actually, I think it was early 2020 was when I took this thing out of service. And the reason why I didn't bother to put anything newer on it was because this thing was running 1709 fantastic. But, of course, newer builds probably wouldn't be the same. So we're going to, again, do some testing here. This machine has an AMD Athlon 64 single-core processor. I can't remember exactly the type. We have 3 gigabytes of DDR400 memory. We're using the original GeForce 6100 integrated graphics on the motherboard. And we have a 160 gigabyte Hitachi IDE hard drive. I just dropped this in a few minutes ago because the 80 gigabyte Hitachi Death Star was going bad. It had bad sectors. I noticed this thing was running a little bit on the slow side, so ran Crystal Disk Info, and it determined that the hard drive was going bad, so swapped it. So this machine is, I'd say, minus more RAM in the hard drive swap, it's practically in its original state. So what we're going to do is we're going to install a 32-bit version of Windows 10 1507. And we're going to see how this thing runs. I'm going to only install minimal software applications. Like, for example, probably a Google Chrome, for example, I'll install that. But other than that, I'm going to install Windows 10 and install any needed drivers this thing will need. This thing will need a specific graphics driver. And we'll just have a look around at the how it runs, more or less, how quick it starts up, stuff like that. And then what we'll do is we'll upgrade straight to Windows 10 20H2 and see how it runs in. So, let's go and get started.
Okay, so now we'll go ahead and get this installed. So, as you can see, the installation here is not really much different than the current Windows 10 installer, except for the fact that this one is copyrighted 2015. So this is pretty straightforward. Same as installing Windows 7, pretty much. Also the same as, about the same as installing Vista as well, with some exceptions. So this machine already has a digital entitlement, so we don't have to enter a key here, so we'll skip this. And we'll select Windows 10 Pro. Accept the license terms, do a custom, new, apply, okay. And of course, since this system is a MBR, it's only going to create just the primary partition and a system partition, system reserve partition. So we'll select next and we'll let this install. And we'll pick back up once this is done. Okay, everybody. So now we're at the setup, or at least the out of box experience, and it's noticeably different back then compared to what it is now. I think maybe this might have been the only version of Windows 10. Maybe 1509 did it as well. If you selected I didn't have a product key, and you wouldn't install the OS, you may get this prompt and set up. Now I don't have this thing connected to the internet, so it wouldn't know yet that there is a digital license out there for it. So we're just going to go ahead and hit do this later. And I'm going to choose customize settings. You see the little link over here on the left, because you know, of course they want you to use express settings. But no, we're going to customize it. We're going to turn all this stuff off. And you had to go through each page one by one by one. And we're missing a driver for graphics. And I think I mentioned earlier in this video I'm going to install a special driver for this thing. It's because I don't think, I believe from my understanding, the GeForce 6100 and similar NVIDIA graphics solutions from that time period did not natively support Windows 10. They'll have a patch driver that actually worked. So I did not have the Ethernet cable plugged in, so it couldn't go online to try to force me to create a Microsoft account. So now we can create a local account. I always suggest that when you install Windows 10, do not connect to the internet yet. Just run through setup and create your local account. That's what we're going to select next. Yeah, it's been so long since I have set up Windows 10, at least this version, 1507. And of course, that's my shortcut to get around the, hi, we're setting things up for you. Let's go ahead and waste your time while we set things up for you in the background. No, I want to get to the desktop, dadgummit. So I'm gonna go ahead and get in here, and I'm gonna fetch that driver. It's in my files. Got to go fetch it, and I'll install it. And I think that's the only one we'll need. So let's get you a look here at the Windows 10 desktop. It's of course it looks similar to what you have in the current build of Windows 10. And this computer is keeping track of date and time. It's been sitting unplugged for a while, so that's pretty amazing. CMOS battery must be good. So now we'll go ahead and connect our Ethernet cable. There's a few things I'll need to do, so I'll go ahead and take care of those real quick. Oh yes, first thing. What I always try to do is kill OneDrive setup. might be a little too late. And then go ahead and disable it. Remember starting again. That's how you can stop OneDrive from installing on your system, by the way. You have to do this for every user account you set up, by the way. And I'm going to go ahead and fetch a couple of files real quick. Since we're running Windows 10 Pro, we can go ahead and run this registry fix that will stop Windows Update from automatically downloading and installing updates. It changes a group policy setting to notify to download. That way it won't try to auto-install updates when new feature builds on us. So that's taken care of. Now I'll go ahead and fetch the driver I need. Okay, so I got the link to the driver files I need, so I'll go into Device Manager and install drivers. And one thing I like about this older version of Windows 10 is the menus, the right-click menus, they're the classic style. They're not so freaking big. So go to Device Manager. And we'll choose Update Driver. This should locate the driver we need. And this will get us a better functioning display. And while that's running, let's go ahead and pull up Task Manager. Yes, we'll install. And there's your general look at CPU and memory usage. Now, even the original Windows 10 did seem to be a bit heavy on CPU use, but I'm not sure if I mentioned it or not, but it seemed like the original Windows 10, once it was all set up, it was very lightweight and not too resource intensive. It actually seemed faster than Windows 7 on comparable hardware, especially this older stuff. So that was, when Windows 10 came out, it was something I definitely, any chance I got on older stuff like this system here that needed, of course, had Windows 7, I would actually do a, of course, free upgrade to Windows 10. And it would work out really well, actually. Okay, so we've got the drivers installed for the GeForce 6100 graphics. And yeah, we'll go and restart. So here is a reboot, which I don't have my phone with me to do a time. But I'll use the camera to battery meter. That's funny. We'll use the camera's timer to time the restart. I'm going to start the time now. So it was about a minute and 6 seconds. So not the fastest startup, But of course, we did install a graphics driver and stuff like that. So we're gonna, I'm gonna go ahead and install a few other different things, and we'll go from there. Okay, everybody. So I've installed Google Chrome. I think that's about all I'm going to install, really, to be honest, because this video is really to be about just the base operating system overall. So we'll pull Task Manager back up again. You can see we're sitting at pretty low usage of the CPU and just 23% usage of the memory. Got 3 gigs of RAM installed in this thing. So this is 1507, and that's the start menu, by the way. And the start menu has changed a little bit since this version of Windows 10. Going to settings. Yeah, it's just crazy how much has changed in Windows 10. I mean, from a glance, it looks real similar, but when you get really into the details, there's quite a difference between the older one and the newer one. So, we go to System. We go to About. You can see that we we should be able to see the Windows 10 version. maybe the 1507 doesn't show it right here. It's, like I say, it's been so long since I've used this build of Windows 10. But we're running 1507. Go back to settings home. It should have activated. Let's see here. Yep, Windows 10 Pro, Windows is activated. See, there's so much that has actually changed. But, of course, this is running the setup. The settings window is up and running. And let's just look at a few different things here. In a way, I kind of like the older start menu style better than the newer one. There's the apps that you get out of the box, and it hasn't had a chance to really go online and download any other ones. So we'll go ahead and do again. Here's a look at your look at the vitals. Now I'll go and do a restart, and I'm going to time the startup this time. I do have my phone now. And what I'll do is, like last time, I'll time it from when it starts booting Windows. So, go ahead and restart. So I started the timer as soon as it picked up the hard drive. So I also end up doing a timed startup with fast startup to see how it does. Not bad. So 43 seconds. That's definitely an improvement over what it was earlier. yeah. Now, of course, we're working with rather old specs, but I mean, the thing is, Windows 10, it was it's safe to say it was usable on this kind of system. I mean, you could use it pretty well. So. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert my USB stick for Windows 10 20H2, and we're going to go and do an upgrade to it. Matter of fact, before I do that, let's just pull up, just for fun, let's pull up the old Edge one time. Yeah, guys, this is the legacy Microsoft Edge that came out. And look here, it's already asking me to download the new Edge. Watch this. Wait for it to pop up. Now, I should mention that certain things like like browsing the web on this kind of hardware won't be the fastest, but eh. So you can see they're telling you, oh, you need to upgrade to the new Edge. Okay, guys, so I'm about to do a restart. Instead, I'm going to shut down the system and start it back up. That way, we will initialize and use the Windows 10 fast startup. So, yeah, we had 46 seconds with the conventional startup. So, I'm going to go ahead and reset the timer to zero. I'm going to shut this down. And then we'll do a startup. I'm not going to actually time the shutdown. Okay, there it shut off in case you want to count the time. I didn't time the shutdown because, of course, it's saving all the stuff to the hard drive to do a fast startup. It's really like the equivalent of doing a hibernation. So, we're going to start this back up. And we'll see how it does with fast startup. Okay. Wow, 1:57. Minute and 57 seconds is what we got. Yeah, that was pretty pathetic. So maybe on stuff this old, you might be better off disabling fast startup. I mean, who knows? We'll see how it does. Excuse me, we'll see how it does with Windows 10 20H2. So now we'll go ahead and install Windows 10 20H2. It's on my flash drive here. We're just going to insert it. And we'll start the installation from Windows 10 1507. Now, I'm not going to go through and install every single build of Windows 10. But at the end of the video, I will go and discuss, in particular, my favorite build of Windows 10 for like stuff like this. And I guess I'll cover more of the whole purpose of this video, I guess we could say. So, go ahead and get started here with this installation. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose, when it asks, I'm going to do select nothing. Have it save nothing. No programs, no files. That way it'll pretty much do a clean installation of Windows 10. That way we're starting with a clean slate. And I'll go back and install the driver and also install Chrome. Even though I didn't really use Chrome, I figured it's installed anyway. I'll select not right now. And I think, as I mentioned earlier in the video, I always prefer to disconnect the internet when doing a Windows 10 installation. And we'll let this set up and we'll go from there. One thing that I honestly hate about Windows 10 setup from within Windows is, instead of asking you this question here first or giving you the option to choose what to keep, it has to go through, check and see if you got enough space,
making sure you're ready to install, check and see if you have any incompatible software installed, nag you about that first, and once that's all said and done, then it asks you, it gives you options to change what to keep. And then you just like nothing, and it has to go through this all again, making sure you're ready to install. Yeah, so it is a waste of time when you have to do this here twice. So that's something they really need to address. Before it goes through the making sure you're ready to install, making sure you have enough space, blah, 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 it needs to ask you, what do you want to do? Do you want to keep everything? Do you want to keep just your files, or do you want to keep nothing? See, now, keep nothing. It's one thing I can't stand about the installer, and it amazes me that they have failed to address this after, about 6 years of Windows 10. Okay, so now we're at the out-of-the-box experience setup for Windows 10 20H2. And of course, as you can see, things look a lot more familiar now. This is how the Windows 10 setup has been for quite a little while now. I think for at least since the past couple of years. So, I'm going to set this up here. One thing you might notice right away is even the setup part of Windows 10 20H2 is significantly slower than the setup of the old Windows 10 1507. Now this slowdown didn't really seem to be a problem until, I'd say, for older stuff like this machine here. Things didn't really seem to start slowing way down until probably build 1803 or 1809. It seemed like 1507, 1511, 1607, along with, I can't remember if there was another build in 2016, but also 1703 and 1709. They all seemed to run really well, or at least fairly well, on older stuff like this machine here. But once you start getting into 1803, 1809, 1903, 1909, 2004, and 20H2, it's just, these builds are just, it's horrible as far as resources goes. And I'm sure the CPU is probably pegged out 100% right now. We're just sitting here at just a moment. Just a very long freaking moment. Except for I take this opportunity to talk about this. Right now, since we're waiting. and this is part of what I was going to talk about in the end of the video. Is Windows 10. something. We get this right here. OB keyboard. Something went wrong. This is the same error as I got, by the way, on the video where I was demonstrating the laptop CPU in a desktop platform, more or less socket 754. This is socket 939, by the way. So we get these errors. It's because it just sits there and errors out. And of course it'll probably error out when everything else we're on the network part. And watch this, let's see what happens. I have the Ethernet cable disconnected. Now when I was installing Windows 10, I believe it was 2004, on a Athlon 64 single core socket 754 and Enforce 3250 platform, this setup errored out on everything. It's everything. There is a way we'll be able to get Windows 10 eventually installed on here, but it's going to take a moment to get that figured out. It's going to probably involve booting into safe mode and activating the administrator account
That way we can get in and it literally bypasses OBE and also forcing a registry fix to stop it from ever prompting this OBE ever again. That was how I managed to get it installed in the video where I demonstrated the laptop CPU in a desktop. More or less the same as 74. So I'm pretty sure it's going to error out here in a second. And from the way this thing sounds, it sounds like, let me see here. The CPU heatsink is quite warm, so it's likely pegging the CPU at 100%. Oh, look here. Finally. Any day now. And for those of you who watch my videos, you may have recalled the video where I demonstrated Windows Vista on a netbook alongside a different netbook, a newer netbook running Windows 10 2004. Of course, Windows Vista, it was like it ran perfectly on an Atom N270. Yet on the other netbook with the Atom N450. With Windows 10 2004, it was just a pile of garbage. It was practically unusable. It just sat at 100% practically all the time. With no third-party software, just the base Windows 10 operating system, just sitting there in Task Manager, pegged at 100% all the time. Yeah, we're just sitting here. Is it finally going to go? So, I guess the point is, what Microsoft really should have done with this operating system, with Windows 10, is instead of retiring support for every old build, they should have allowed support to continue from one of the previous builds. For example, 1709 would have been a good one. They should have continued updates and support for 1709. That way, legacy hardware like what I'm running here will continue to be somewhat usable. I mean, this thing, although it was not the fastest in the world, you could see it was usable. It was running, it was usable. You could do basic stuff with it. But with this build of Windows 10, heck, I don't know if we're going to be able to get installed without having to go through a bunch of hoops. And look, something went wrong. Something went wrong, yeah, something went wrong, all right. Now, the problem, again, that I had with the video involving the old Socket 754 setup was I could not even create a user account. Therefore, I could not log in using the built-in out-of-box experience. I had to go into safe mode, start up. I think it had a startup command prompt to activate and start the administrator account. That way I could log into the system and then create a user account. It was just a pain in the butt. So I'll resume this video once we get somewhere. And here we go again. Something went wrong. And all I can do is try again. This was the dead end. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go into safe mode. And here's another thing I don't like about Windows 10 in general. Is, of course, you don't have the simple press the F8 key to invoke the advanced setup options. You have to do this. You have to start the machine up. And once it starts booting, you have to purposely kill the startup. You have to do this usually one or two times. And this time around, you have to wait for it to do this preparing all Mac repair bullcrap. Whereas with Windows 7, you just press the F8 key, get your advanced options, and just go to safe mode. You don't have to go through a bunch of hoops in Windows 7 like you have to do in Windows 8 and Windows 10. Diagnosing your PC. Oh, sure. Quit wasting my time. Just give me advanced startup options, for goodness sakes. I do find it interesting how the recovery options of Windows 10 seem to work just fine on here. They boot up. You'll see in a sec. It's actually usable. Alright, don't include that. Your PC did not start correctly. Now you think? Here's what I wanted to do the whole time. Troubleshoot. Advanced options. Startup settings. Restart. God. So now that I've thought about it, it will actually start up in the administrator account automatically. So I'll select option 5. Safe mode with networking. And what we'll do is we'll go in there and create a user account. So that way this thing can actually log into something. So yeah, the sad thing is this is why Microsoft should have offered continued support for an older build of Windows 10 such as 1709, because it can actually run on older stuff, whereas the newer build, simply you came and installed a thing. Now, there's a chance, had I selected the save everything option, it probably would have did an in-place upgrade to Windows 10 20H2. But you can't clean start without going through a bunch of hoops, as you're seeing right now. Now, technically, you could... I'm sure you could install Windows 10 1709, but you'll be running a version of Windows 10 that's no longer receiving updates, and of course Windows Update will just try to constantly install a new feature build. Oh, look! Why is it doing this? I mean, I thought we did select safe mode, right? Okay, everybody, so now 1803 has just installed. Let's see what happens here. And as you can see, it is working just fine. The out-of-box experience, anyway. Why is this not the case with Windows 10, the newer build of Windows 10, for example? Why does it not work on the newer build of Windows 10? I don't know. But what we'll do is we'll get this installed, and I'll just, what I'll end up doing is I will just probably do an in-place upgrade to Windows 10 2020H2. Yeah, because you think about it, the setup is really no different. I mean, at least from a visual standpoint. So apparently, since Windows 10 1803 or maybe 1809, things have gotten really resource intensive with the operating system. Kill OneDrive setup. Once this comes up, it's trying to do everything at once, of course, which on an old single core CPU is kind of brutal. Kill the process and then go over here to startup and disable it. Now stop it from ever installing. And you can see we're missing the graphics driver. So what I'll do is I'll actually go ahead and install the graphics driver that we need and a couple of miscellaneous things, and we'll redo our tests again. Okay, everybody, so now we're going to do a startup test of Windows 10 1803 on this old computer and see what we get out of it. And of course, I'm not going to start the timer until we get to where it actually boots into Windows. Alright. So this will be the fast startup, or supposedly fast startup, when you consider how it performed with the with Windows 10 1507. Wow, 3 minutes and 21 seconds. Yeah, that's pretty pathetic. God, man. Okay, so let's have a look in Task Manager. So the only thing I did to this was I installed the graphics driver. And I installed Chrome. Now I should mention, on hardware this old Windows 10, this is not going to be all that great, but with the earlier Windows 10, it was usable. Now with the later Windows 10, it's not that great. But this is Windows 10, I believe it was 1803, and for I guess for a system this old, it's not the worst. I mean, with all things considered, when you look at performance. CPU usage is coming down as things are getting started and what have you. RAM usage is, it's got 1 gig of RAM in use, physical RAM at least. But I must say, yeah, we're back at 100%. I must say that a single core processor on Windows 10 is just. Or just a single core CPU in today's age. Okay, so Google Chrome is updating. That's what's going on. Yeah, it's installing a new version of Chrome, I guess. Yeah, it's funny to mention, I saw a post recently talking about how Google Chrome will soon require SSC 3 support. And it mentioned that the Athlon 64s were not compatible. Or at least some website doing a review about that, or just doing a news article about it, was talking about how your Athlon 64 won't be compatible, but it only applies to certain models. Matter of fact, some models of Athlon 64s, even back to a Socket 754, actually have SSE 3 support. I believe this Socket 939 Venice Core actually does have SSC 3. Alright, so it looks like Chrome finished installing, so we'll go ahead and restart this machine. So, this time, we'll be able to time it on a raw startup and not a quote-unquote fast startup. Let's see if we beat 3 minutes and 21 seconds in the conventional startup mode. I started just a tad late there. See, again, I believe it was 3 minutes and 21 seconds was the time last for the fast startup. We look at this. Wow. It only took us 30 seconds to get to the please wait screen. Let's see if we can get to the desktop before a minute. Come on, you can do it. Hey, hard drives are racing. Okay, a minute and change. Okay, a minute and 9 seconds to the desktop. So, I know I'll be doing well once I can get Explorer up, go to the classic control panel. Did I even launch Task Manager? I don't think I did. See, for something this old, you would expect it to be a bit sluggish. So, but it is usable. So what I'm going to do after this, I'll launch Chrome real quick. Not there's much we'll really do with it. But what I'll do after this is I will do an in-place upgrade to Windows 10 20H2. Alright, so what we're going to do now is to show you guys, if you're running something this old and you find that the fast startup is not so fast after all, what you can do is you can go to Power Options, System Settings, Change Settings that are currently unavailable, and turn that crap off right there. Save Changes. Bingo. So, the past two startup tests, we've determined on this old machine that fast startup ain't so fast after all, so we're going to keep it disabled. So we're about a couple minutes into this startup, so let's launch Chrome. Just to show you that the newer software gets, it's just something this old, it gets less and less usable. But anyways, Yeah, my grandpa was running this machine up until early 2020. And it had Windows 10 1709 on it. Yeah, I can say that not only Windows 10, but also over the past past year, other software titles, like Chrome and what have you, everything has gotten heavier and heavier, which is, you know, to be expected, but you can see that. Yeah, like launching YouTube on this thing, it's just crazy. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and insert the USB stick for Windows 10 20H2. And what we'll do is we'll do an in-place upgrade this time, retaining programs and files. So we'll see, provided we're able to bypass the out-of-box experience, if Windows 10 20H2 will even run on this thing. And see, that's getting back to the original point of the video, is Windows 10, you think about it, Windows 10 1507 versus Windows 10 20H2, It's like two different operating systems, yet they're both called Windows 10. And see, the thing is, the fact that Windows 10, the operating system, at least under the hood, has changed so much that for some computers, things simply won't work. You'll either run into severe performance issues, but also you may run into issues with driver support or issues with software support. I mean, there's software tiles and drivers that will work on Windows 10, 1507, or 1511, or 1709, or heck, even 1803, that simply will not work on Windows 10, 1903, 1909, 2004, or 20H2. Therefore, I personally think that at least one older build of Windows 10 should still have support. This treatment should not apply just to Enterprise. I mean, with the LTSB or LTSC, they should have made at least one version of Windows 10 eligible for extended servicing of updates and stuff. I mean, at least security, at least just security updates. So what we'll do is we'll let this install and we'll continue from there. Okay, everybody, so I was able to finally get Windows 10 20H2 installed on this thing after having to jump through a bunch of hurdles, more or less. So I did an in-place upgrade from the previous build I had on here, which essentially bypassed the OOBE or iBox experience that you would get with a clean install, which is, I tell you, that's really sad. That the OOBE experience, or at least the out-of-box setup is so, it's basically it's super buggy on low-end hardware. You get the stalling out, and you get those errors, and you get pretty much stuck where you can't really set the thing up. And what kills me is even in safe mode, you get it. And so it kind of defeats the purpose of safe mode, in my opinion. Even if you start safe mode without networking, it would probably still ask you to connect to the internet if the setup was able to properly run. But so we'll go ahead and restart the computer to show you how it runs with Windows 10 20H2. And as I would expect, it's not going to run super fast. Now, before I do that, we'll just try to pull up settings here. If it'll even pull that up. Okay, it did. So, if we go to system, We'll look at the Windows 10 build. Eventually we'll get there. So there you are, Windows 10 Pro 20H2. So we'll go ahead and restart this thing. And as you may know, I disabled Fast Startup because, of course, as we have seen, it's not so fast after all. And so I'll time the startup as usual. Start it when it starts booting Windows. Look, I guess I forgot to apply the register key to bypass this crap here. So it looks like it would have been about a minute and 30 seconds. We'll have to do this again. Okay, we'll restart it yet again. Okay, so a minute and 13 seconds to the desktop. Definitely not what you would want to be using as your daily driver. So I guess to wrap up this video, which I'm about done with this thing. This video took way longer to make than I anticipated. But I guess what I'm trying to say here about Windows 10 is I just simply don't like the fact that despite it being called Windows 10 all the way back since 2015, the Windows 10 we know today is quite a bit different than the Windows 10 that came out in 2015. Can you imagine, like, for example, Windows XP? You know, Windows XP came out in 2001 and it was serviced until 2014. It got, of course, three different service packs, but the service packs, at least in my opinion, now, this would depend on the kind of hardware you were running, but it seemed like the service packs didn't really impact the performance of the operating system all that much. I mean, you did get some new features here and there, but other than that, I mean, you could take Windows XP Service Pack 3 and, for example, run it on, let's say, maybe a Pentium 2. Not that I recommend that, but let's say a common computer that came out around the time of Windows XP. Let's say that Windows XP came out. Let's say a Pentium 4 Socket 478 Willimette. or heck, even socket 423 Willamette, like you, for example, like what was featured in recently on Budget Build Official, that channel. Let's take a system like that, for example, that kind of hardware that was out around the time Windows XP's launch. You could, Windows XP would typically run fine on that hardware throughout Windows XP's service life, but for example, Windows 10, now of course, an old Windows 10 computer will still run the current Windows 10 build just fine, but let's say some older systems like what I'm using for this example, although kind of extreme, while they could run Windows 10 1507 pretty well, as you've seen, it struggles quite a bit even in installing Windows 10 20H2. So, you know, I guess I should say they should have called it Windows 10.1, 10.2, 10.3, 10.4, 10.5, 10.6. And they should have allowed an older build of Windows 10 to remain, or at least to keep getting updates for a longer service span. So, now, the performance aspect is just one thing. Now, Windows 10, for example, on the Mentor Lux, for example, I remember when I was upgrading to a certain build of Windows 10, I had to reinstall or had to upgrade my RAID drivers. Yeah. In order to actually upgrade to a newer build of Windows 10, I had to install new RAID drivers, and there were certain instances where certain software that worked fine with, was it Windows 10 1709, which I think was the first build of Windows 10 that got installed on the current Mintower Lux with the Ryzen 7 1700X. I think it's running like 1903 right now, or 1909. But there were certain instances where the newer builds of Windows 10 will not quite work so well with certain software tiles that would work with that with the older Windows 10 build. But I guess that kind of is a drive home point here, so I'm going to go ahead and end this video. This video, again, it's been drug out way longer than I anticipated, but I still want to share it with you guys. Hopefully you enjoy it for what it is. So anyways, thanks for watching. Well, everybody, that's it for this video, but don't forget there's a lot more interesting stuff on the channel to check out. Also, if this is your first time visiting this channel, feel free to subscribe to keep your channel, and also don't forget to tick the bell so that way we'll get notified of new video posts. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, but if you really didn't like it, there is the alternative option available as well. Also, feel free to check out my second channel, CubeComp MTDX. There you'll find videos about bicycling, weather, elevator tours, and all sorts of other neat, interesting stuff. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Feel free to come back, and thank you for your support.